Hello students, this video is regarding an important update about Capgemini's updated recruitment process for the students of 2021 batch. Students from various colleges have started receiving information from their training and placement department about Capgemini planning to conduct virtual or online drive for the students of their college. So many students started asking us about the updated pattern. So in this video, we are going to discuss in detail about the updated pattern for Capgemini this year. One thing you need to keep in mind, Capgemini does not conduct a national level drive like TCS or Wipro. It hires students from specific colleges which they have partnered with. So before starting, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because any further updates regarding campus and off-campus drives, sample questions, preparation strategies will be uploading on our YouTube channel. So don't forget to subscribe it and press the bell icon for instant notifications. So let's begin now. So first, let us check what is the eligibility criteria. Okay. So first you need to check if your college is Capgemini partner college. You need to contact your placement head and check with him if Capgemini is planning to hire the students of your college. Secondly, you must be a BE, BTech or MCS student. Most probably the drive will be for computer science, IT and circuit branch students. This may differ from college to college. Contact your placement head to clarify this particular point. The most probable criteria would be minimum 60% in 10th, 12th and graduation. You should not have any active backlogs. And probably there would be a 1 year gap allowed between 12th and first year of graduation. The designation would be senior analyst, and the probable package would be 3.8 lakhs per annum. It may vary according to college. So first, let us put some light on the old pattern. In the old pattern, there were 4 to 5 rounds. The first round was analytical section, which was based on the quantitative aptitude, logical reasoning, and there were 32 questions. There was one essay writing questions. After that, there was a pseudocode round with 20 questions. And then there was technical and HR interview. Now, before proceeding with the new pattern, I would like to give a disclaimer that the new process which we will be discussing in this video is based on the information received from various sources or students. If there are any changes, then we will be updating it periodically. You need to understand that this is the first time that Capgemini has changed their pattern, and there can be some differences in the process discussed here and the actual process. So as we have discussed the old pattern, let's check the new pattern. So new pattern is going to have, you can say, 5 rounds. The first will be a technical assessment, that is the first will be technical assessment pseudocode round. Second one will be MCQ based English communication test. The third will be game based aptitude test. Fourth will be behavioral competency profiling. And last would be technical and HR interview. Now you can check the difference. Basically, the first round in the old pattern was analytical section, which consisted of quantitative aptitude and logical reasoning, which is eliminated this time. They have even eliminated essay writing, and instead of essay writing, they have put MCQ based English communication test. Apart from that, the pseudocode round, which was the third round last year, so they have put it in the first round. The first round you are going to face is the pseudocode round. After that, there is one new thing, that is a game-based aptitude test. So instead of this analytical section, they have put this game-based aptitude test. Apart from that, there is one new round, that is behavioral competency profiling. And then there is a but obvious technical and HR interview. So we are going to discuss in detail about each of these rounds. So first is the pseudocode round, which is going to be an elimination round. Okay. So you need to crack this particular round to go to the next round. So different types of pseudocode questions are like, you will be given a pseudocode and you need to check for errors in that code, or you need to complete the pseudocode to get a desired output. There will be some code snippet also. You will be also required to write a logic of program to get the desired output mentioned in the question. So there are various types of pseudocode questions. So the main hurdle, the first hurdle you can say, is the pseudocode round if you want to go to further rounds. Next is a MCQ based English communication test. This is again an elimination round. The probable topics on which this particular MCQ test will be like sentence completion using adverbs, nouns, adjectives, filling the blanks using articles, prepositions. There can be probable questions on synonyms, that is similar word meanings, that is words with similar meanings. there can be spelling based questions. You need to select the correct spelling. So these kind of questions are probable in the MCQ based English communication test. So once you clear this particular round, then there is a game based aptitude test. Now this is something new which Capgemini has introduced. There are some probable games like grid challenge, motion challenge, switch challenge, digit challenge. Okay, so on the screen you can check different kinds of games. So these are the probable games. Okay, there can be some questions based on deductive logical reasoning. These are also, it is also a type of game. Now the most important is, you need not become nervous or afraid of this particular round, because there is a chance that before every game module you will have a chance to practice it, get familiar before starting the actual test. So before every game module you will have a chance to get familiar with what exactly the game is. So you need not worry about that. After that there will be a behavioral competency profiling. This is a non-elimination round. So this is, from this there will be no one will be eliminated. So once you crack the previous game based aptitude test, you are sure that you will be entering the interview round. So what they are going to do in this round is basically looking for your behavior and interaction with others. It is checking your team skills and your profile. So I am just giving you two examples. What exactly is behavioral competency profiling? It does not mean that the same examples would be there in the exam, but let me give you an example. For example, there is a statement given, is capable of adequately persuading others about something. So persuading is maybe convincing. Okay. So now after reading this statement, you need to select one of the options. Now what are the options? Whether that statement applies to me, whether it sometimes applies to me, whether it regularly applies to me, or whether it always applies to me. Okay. So now you can check, after reading the statement, you need to select appropriate option. So there is no correct or wrong answer in this. Every answer you need to select according to your personality, and then they will be checking your behavior accordingly. Second, you can check example, often spontaneously takes charge or is appointed by others as a leader. So again, in this also you need to check whether this particular statement applies to you or doesn't apply to you. So such type of questions are generally there in behavioral competency profiling. Last but not the least will be the technical and HR interview round, which you need to prepare like just any other company. In this video, I'm not going into details about technical and HR interview. We'll be definitely making some videos for technical and HR interview preparation. Now, again, I'm telling, the new process which we have discussed in this video is based on the information received from various sources. If there are any changes, we'll be updating it periodically on our YouTube channel. Make sure you press the bell icon and subscribe, so that you will get immediate notifications. Now the main question which you might face is how to prepare. So you can prepare with Capgemini's new pattern specific preparation pack by Talent Battle. So I'll just tell what we are going to provide in this particular preparation pack. That is, we are going to provide around 350 plus pseudocode questions with solutions, which is the first round, very important. Secondly, we are going to provide MCQ based English communication test for practice. Apart from that, basic verbal ability lectures will be there to clear the concept needed for that MCQ based English communication test. We are going to provide you guidance to prepare for the game based aptitude round. Apart from that, 150 plus behavioral competency profiling questions will be given to you, so that you get an idea what type of questions are there. And there will be one mock interview where you will be facing technical and personal interview questions. Apart from that, we are giving one add-on. That is a complete aptitude preparation video course useful for other companies. As you can check, Capgemini is having a pattern wherein their aptitude part, the quantitative aptitude, logical reasoning, verbal ability part in the normal question format is less. But we are giving this add-on so that after this company, if you are preparing for any other company, it will be useful for you. So the price of this package is ₹1599. And we are starting with the lectures from 12th of August. So if you are interested, the link for this particular package is given in the description of this video. If you have any doubts regarding the package, you can WhatsApp us or message us on our website. The WhatsApp number is given in the description of this video. Apart from that, make sure you join our placement preparatory WhatsApp group and Telegram channel. We'll be constantly updating with new opportunities, any update regarding Capgemini or any other company. So make sure you join that. It is completely free to join. And thank you for watching this video patiently. If you have any questions, you can comment or you can WhatsApp us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications. Thank you.